And in this video lecture, I'm going to talk about few quick tips that can help you in your last minute exam preparation. If you are preparing for July's NET exam and you are struggling with preparation, with the endless course, then don't worry. These quick tips and study strategy will help you in your preparation. So let's start and make a note of all these tips and strategy that I am giving. The first tip that I would like to give you is that do not get influenced by your friends' preparation. Guys, this might seem to be a very, very simple suggestion that I'm offering, but I'm telling you the effect that it has on the mind of a student is way too large. What happens is that we all have this tendency that if there are other friends of ours who are giving the same exam, we tend to call them and ask them, tumne kitna padha, kitni tayari hui, how much you have covered till now, what all topics are left, what all topics you have covered, what books are you referring. All these questions keep on popping up in our head and we try to ask as many of them to our friends. What happens is that somewhere everybody is very different and everybody follows a different strategy, because no one strategy can be successful in all cases. Everybody needs to take up a different strategy which suits best for his own study schedule. Now what happens is that when you ask your friend how much you have covered, and if suppose your friend says that he has covered a lot more than what you have done, in that case you will get tensed, you will try to skip through topics, you will try to revise at a very, very high speed so that you can match to his speed. You can also cover the same amount of data that he has covered. But this will not give you any good results. This will only create tension in your head. On the other hand, I have seen people who get so relaxed when they call their friends and their friends tell them that they have not studied anything. Now that person thinks that he has studied a lot more, and that confidence turns into overconfidence and that person stops studying further. So in both the cases, in the case when friend has not studied anything and in the case when friend has studied a lot more than what you have studied, in both the cases you will get affected, and you will get affected negatively. So it's always better that you should be very clear about your own strategy. Stick to the strategy that you find best for yourself and don't get influenced by what other people are doing. When I was preparing for my NET exam, there were a lot of friends of mine who went to Delhi to attend coaching classes. Some of them went to other places and some of them were taking some online coaching. So we used to have a chit chat on and off, and whenever I used to ask them kitna padha, kya padha, every time they used to tell me something which I have not studied or I might not have given enough time, and then that somewhere demoralized me, that somewhere made me question my own ability. Then after a period of time I decided that every time I'll call them, I will not be discussing whatever they have studied. I made it very clear to them that let's not discuss what you have studied, because somewhere I feel depressed, I feel helpless after talking to you, because I feel that you have prepared a lot more and that somewhere gives me a sense of guilt. On the other hand, the same thing happened with them also, that whenever they used to ask me what I have studied, I would have also studied certain things that they might not have studied till then. So the same thing happened with them. So it's always good that you don't focus your energy into knowing what is going in other person's life. So dedicate yourself in your study routine and don't get influenced by what your friend tells you. The second advice that I would like to give you is that please say no to new resources now. I have seen this thing in almost all students, that whenever the last month of exam is approaching, they all tend to get overwhelmed with new set of information that they are getting from different sources. So some people will tell you that these writers are very important. Some people might give you a book and tell you that this book must be read if you want to clear NET. Some people might give you a set of few pages of their notes and tell you that these notes, so you have to learn. So all these things will keep on happening around you, and that is a part of life. What you need to do is that please don't focus on all such things, because if you look at your exam preparation, you have devoted about 4 to 6 months, and in that period of 4 to 6 months you have already covered a lot of things. If you look at the piles of notes that you have made in this period of 4 to 6 months, you will find it enough. okay, and you would not be able to revise those notes if you enter into a realm of new resources. Realm of new resources is endless. NET syllabus is so vast that even if you study for next 5 years, you will never be able to complete everything. Even after 5 years, you'll see that there would be writers, there would be texts, there would be books that you will have to study further. So you need to restrict yourself to limited set of data. Whatever you have made, just focus on that, revise that. It will be more beneficial than learning new material. Because if you already know 20 postmodern writers and if you revise them thoroughly, that would be of a lot more benefit than starting 10 new postmodern writers today. Because these 10 new postmodern writers will not be registered so easily in your brain. You will forget it. Okay, you might study 100 new writers in this month and you don't revise them, you will not remember any of them on the exam day. And that will be foolishness. So it's always important that whatever you have studied till now, just focus on that data, revise them, and look at the areas which need your attention. For example, if you have read 20 postmodern writers, out of that there are 8 writers which you think are not on your tips, then go and read them again, go and revise them again, so that all these 20 writers will be on your tips. That is how you need to channelize your last 1 month. The third important tip is that make quick pointers. Now, what are quick pointers? I'll tell you, but then you must remember that these quick pointers is the thing that will give you that winning edge. Okay, what happens is, guys, that when I was preparing for NET exam, I made about 12-13 notebooks of handwritten notes. Apart from those notes, I also made notes on Evernote. So there were like these two sets of notes that I had to refer in the period of 1 month. Now, I kept on revising from these notebooks, but what I found while I was revising was that whenever I revise about 5 pages, there will be 2 or 3 points which I still don't remember. Okay, what I used to do was that while I was revising each and every notebook, I made sure that I wrote those 2-3 points which I forget repeatedly on a separate copy. And this is the copy that I made during my last month. What I did was that I just wrote roughly all the points which I kept on forgetting. And if you look at the kind of notes that I've made, they are messy, but then it's all fine, because when I was revising my handwritten notes, I was revising my Evernote, I found that there were few points which I kept on forgetting, and it was important that I revise them again and again. It was no point revising those 12 copies for 10 times. It is more beneficial if I revise each copy once, and then us copy mein jo points hai, jo main baar baar bhool rahi hu, unhe main 4-5 baar revise karu. So if you collect all the data that I revised, out of that data there were these 1200 points which I kept on forgetting, and I wrote this in a separate copy. And what I did every day before going to night for the next 1 month, I read each and every point. And these points were so easy for me to remember on the day of exam, because I kept on revising these points again. What people do is that they'll keep on revising things, but whatever they are forgetting, they will not make a note of it. You'll revise an entire sheet of paper. You might forget two things and you'll skip that thing. You will not focus your energy on revising those two things. Because if a page contains 12 points, you remember 10 points, that is fine. But in the exam paper, if out of those 12, 2 points come which you don't remember, what will you do? So in that case, it is important that you make a separate copy of the things that you're forgetting repeatedly and which needs more revision than normal things. So this is how you can make quick pointers. Apart from this notebook, you can also write all these points on whiteboard, on sticky notes, and paste them on the wall. You can, if you're making notes on desktop, then make that your wallpaper, so that every time you open your laptop or your desktop, you have those points in front of you. Like I did that, I also pasted all these points in key notes and I pasted it on the walls of my room, as well as I also wrote some of these points on whiteboard. So everywhere I kept on exposing myself to the points which I am forgetting again and again. And you won't believe, guys, out of these 1200 points, 10 questions were asked in NET exam, and I felt myself so fortunate that if these 1200 points were not on my tips, I would have lost those 20 important marks.
The next important advice that I would like to give you is that please make sure that you solve as many previous year papers and mock tests as you can. See, now it is high time that you just need not solve the previous year paper. You now need to sit for a duration of 2 hours and solve the paper and feel as if you are solving the exam paper. Why this is important? You might find that, you know, I can solve a paper in 30 minutes. Why should I sit for next 2 hours and then solve the paper? Just feeling as if I am sitting in exam hall, because that will help you in knowing your own weaknesses. There are times when students make silly mistake in the exam hall. If you do the same mistake during your mock test, you will remember that mistake and you will not commit the same error on the exam day. Also, it might expose you to areas where you need to devote your time, because somewhere when you'll solve a mock test paper, you might come across certain topics which according to you were fully prepared, but when you saw the previous year paper or you saw that particular set of questions, you got confused. That means that that is your weakness. You need to work more on it. So whenever you time yourself and you sit like you are sitting on the exam day and you give a mock test, you will get benefited out of it. Don't ever think that you'll waste 2 hours. You will not. Those 2 hours will save a lot of your time in future, will help you to not do those errors which you did in the mock test. And that is why we have the system of pre-boards, that the same kind of paper, the same kind of environment is created in the pre-board setting, so that the student will not make the same mistakes in the board exam. It is a kind of pre-board exam, because it will tell you your weaknesses so that you can work on it, and on the day of board exam you can give your best, you can learn from your mistakes and not repeat them on the exam day. The same thing you need to do while you are preparing for NET exam. So before I end this video, I would like to give you two quick tips. The first tip is that please don't cry over spilled milk. Now what happens is that I've seen this in so many students, that they keep on regretting what all wrong things they did in past. They might think that humne pehle kyun nahi padhai kari. They might think, why did they waste their time? And all these questions keep on popping up in their head. Now understand this fact, guys, that thinking about such things will never help you. Draw a line to your past. Whatever happened, let it be. Don't crib over what went wrong. Just focus on what all you can do now. Even if you have wasted a lot of time, if you devote yourself completely, I'm telling you, NET is not a very tough exam. There are people who are preparing for more tough exams, who are preparing for like ages for IAS prelims, IAS mains, and they never get fatigued. They never regret their decision. They just keep on working hard. The same strategy you need to build in yourself. Just keep on working hard. Whatever you have done, don't look at the mistakes that you make. Just focus on what you can do right now. The second advice that I would like to give you before I end this video is that please, please don't study the same topic continuously. I have been telling this to my students every time, that I move from module 1 till module 10 and gradually I cover the course. First I take up British literature, then I take up American, and then gradually we will move towards the other modules. But that is when I am making you understand things. I cannot take up restoration and directly jump to Victorian period. The student will not be able to understand what was the political situation which led from restoration to Victorian directly. But when you have already learned things, when you have already understood concept, it is important that you keep on shifting between things, because that will create interest. Okay, otherwise you might feel monotonous. If you're reading Victorian and you're revising Victorian from last 4 days, you might not feel like opening that book or opening that notebook. In that case, keep on shifting between topics. Thoda ye kiya, thoda ye kiya, fir thoda ye revise kiya, thoda ye kiya. So create a kind of platter for yourself so that you feel good. Okay, it should have desserts also, it should have things that you don't like also, it should have a set of main course also. So all these things should be there in your plate every day before you start studying. So this is how you can prepare prepare for next 1 month. I'm wishing you all the best for your revision, and I really hope that you are able to bring laurels to your family and to yourself also. With this, I end my video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because from this week I'm starting a new series in which I'll be giving you tips which can help you on the day of your exam. So if you want to get notified about these videos, please do subscribe to this channel. You can go and visit my website arpitakarwa.com, get a list of writers and tally whether you have covered all of them or not. So with that note, I end my video lecture. Thank you so much. Keep loving literature, happy learning, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.